Hey everybody, what's up? This is Charles with The Visitor. We're here at the TEDx Panama City Conference that's taking place tonight. This is May the 13th. We're going to see a lot of speakers talking about Panama as a cultural center, as a cultural platform. So we're really excited to see the roster. Let's go take a look inside. Okay. Hi, we are with Jacob Larrinaga, and he is the marketing director for Teatro Amador, and we just want to ask him really quick the importance of having this TEDx event with the one-year anniversary of Teatro Amador.
Yeah, I think that having the TEDx Panama City event starting the week of Teatro Amador's anniversary is like ringing a bell, like reminding people like the year has been great, the culture is starting to build up, and we need we need more space for community involvement. We need more people to talk about it. We need more people to recognize they're working in this big cauldron of stuff that's getting cooked. And I think the quality of the speakers and the environment helps people acknowledge they are there and they are with the right instruments to work and grow for a better cultural environment.
Cool. And what made this event possible?
Well, definitely Juan Pablo, Maria Isabel, who are the people with the license in Panama for TEDx Panama City. All the staff for Teatro Amador who believed in the crazy idea of like doing an event in such a small amount of time. All the volunteers who showed up on time. Yuko Watanabe, which was one of the best coordinators that we had over here. Alfonso, for sure, he was a maestro de ceremonia. He also coordinated and talk to the speakers so we can have like a better base of speakers so that everyone could enjoy. And I think basically that, I mean, Casco Antiguo, we couldn't do anything without Casco Antiguo.
Awesome. Now, why don't you introduce our friend here? Queremos preguntarte acerca de la importancia de tener este evento de TEDx Panama City para el nivel cultural en Panamá, para alzar, realzar lo que está pasando aquí.
Bueno, realmente estamos generando mucho ruido, estamos generando impacto, más que a nivel cultural, a nivel intelectual y a nivel espiritual. Con TEDx hablamos de cultura, pero también hablamos de ciencia, también hablamos de botánica, también hablamos de cuántos temas nos pueden inspirar que están allá enterrados. Entonces tratamos de traer todas esas ideas y ponerles un esquema, ¿no? Y ponerles una plataforma que la gente tenga acceso. Entonces es lo que estamos haciendo nosotros realmente, está generando, está permeando en la sociedad panameña y cada vez más gente viene y quiere que venir a estos eventos. Por lo que está ocurriendo en YouTube. Es un fenómeno viral, ¿no? Las charlas que se suben a YouTube se van virales y la gente termina aprendiendo de cosas como física cuántica. Entonces, por eso digo, no solo es cultura. Hoy hablamos un poco sobre cultura, digamos como que tuvo cierto énfasis, pero realmente lo que estamos haciendo para inspirar a la gente, para decir, hey, hay gente que está haciendo ideas, que se pueden hacer diferentes las cosas y nosotros vamos a hacer lo mismo, vamos a hacerlo diferente. Eso es lo que queremos sembrar en las personas, que la gente también puede ir más allá.
Excelente, muchas gracias.
Vale, a ustedes.
Thank you.
Gracias por venir.
Igual. Ready? Listo. Hey everybody, we are with Jahaciel Arrocha, and he got his start with the Danilo Perez Music Foundation and got a scholarship to go study at the Berklee School of Music. He did a great performance here at the TEDx Panama City. We just want to ask him really quick, para ti como músico, I have to do it in English.
You can speak English.
That's cool. Yeah. Thank you. What did it mean for you? ¿Qué significó para ti estar en este escenario? In this cultural thing.
It was very special to be here. I mean, you know, the other six speakers were amazing. Five, I think one was missing. Just be part of it, you know, what they say about cultures. To create a platform where you present your ideas, you know, and your thoughts about something. Mm-hmm. So to me, it was a real honor to be part of it, to tell the truth.
That was a beautiful piece of music that you played, I have to tell you.
Well, that was a classic from Panama. It's called Suspiro Nafa. It's one of the most popular songs here in Panama. So I choose that because part of it, you know, something that's... identify every Panamanian because everybody knows it. And it's part of our culture, and added a little bit of jazz, you know, the jazz idiom and harmonies. If it was inspired, in a way I express myself and tell something about how I view this song, you know, what the song speak to me. So, you know, that's sort of the idea, you know.
Excellent. And what can we see from you coming up this year? Do you have any plans?
Well, there's some stuff cooking. Yeah. I guess that's like you said for now.
Yeah. All right, cool.
Some stuff. Yeah.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much for that performance. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure. Thank you.
Take care.
You too. Oye, muchas gracias.